certain Supreme Court a ruling, I've been getting DMs telling me that my partner's a witch, that I need to medicate him. There have been certain obscenities described about him and my long deceased grandmother. There was actually a poster circulating urging people to murder him on site because he's a ZANU-PF agent, which is a blatant lie. He's not a ZANU-PF agent, nor is he ZANU-PF in any capacity, as if that's a reason to murder someone. We've had death threats, fake screenshots, you name it. And all of that hate and all of that animosity simply because certain people don't agree with him. And it's sad because the MDC used to be a party touted as the people's champion, as a safe place for democracy. Now it's become the flagship of Zimbabwean division at a time when we most need to be united, simply because some people don't want to abide by the law. We've become so divided even in our own respective parties, and I think we're all tired of that. We're tired of the hate. We're tired of the ignorance. Right now, there are Zimbabweans enduring the unendurable. We are in political, social, and economic freefall. There are Zimbabweans are suffering and dying undignified deaths, and you can bet they don't care who's in charge as long as the person in charge is getting things done. But you will still have those who attempt to call outside referees because they have failed. And they have failed to unite with their own countrymen, their own brothers and sisters. They are so desperate just to be picked up and placed into power that they will destroy all of us to make a point. We're tired of that. It's a time that all our leaders, all the older generations, stop telling us that we have to hate each other based on which party or which faction of a party we choose to subscribe to. It's time that all our leaders develop a policy of no Zimba left behind, so that we can all move forward together to build a Zimbabwe that works for everyone.